something like Midjourney, GPT-7? Use some AI tool to create this and call it a day. Anyways, I wanted to put that out of the way because that was probably one of the most laughable.
¿Y ahora? ¿Qué sucede? Hey, ya, 猪头. Vamos a empezar aquí, pero aquí hay demasiadas misiones que no he completado. 直接不小心走进去就直接那个，所以这边还是要解一下，不然我到后面应该经验会不够，会很难打。With a flick of the wrist.
Something to ask. If not over, then through.
The objective of the scalpel sisters. See how the patient reacts when I pray, sister. Stop. Stay your hand, for it's. Perhaps it is our anic. Come, step forward. You are no sister, but that matters none. Every student is welcome. A curse?
Absence.
It is the
a stinging truth.
See? What is the if light is the symptom?
In light is
but you. Look how the we do not wish to see you suffer so. Let us kill you.
You know nothing unusual about the sisters, aside from their menace. You remember a Shiren maxim. Go forth and sow doubt, but do not compel.
And yet thee, how to proceed? I wonder.
God.
Yes. I see. Come, sisters. Soothe me.
Thank you.
The great...
Let's march.
Yes, with ease.
Give me trouble now. Wish I had a bag of holding. Inside. Give it a shot.
只有两个升等哎、欸。
但他不是跑，又跑出去了。I pity you.
Monsters snuffling.
Trapped there. He needs help. My loot. You got it back. How? I've been lost in the shadows so long. He told me about someone he knew. Someone called Housen. Do you know him? The pool of the darkness. The twisted creatures it manifests.Please, hurry. Thaniel, it... Without him...
哎，这是哈尔辛专属任务是不是？
还是说就算没有哈尔辛，我应该也可以达成。
There is work to do.
No rest for the wicked, I see.
What other sins have you been cooking up?
The Absolute's claws have dug deep.
His death was surely a great blow to the cult.
They've gathered an entire army. What's one left?
Okay.
Did a tidy sum back in the day.
Impressive. I don't think even Baldur's Gates is so large. Light on my feet. I need a quick word.
That you have. You may pass the river, but first you must pay.
Get it.
The gold is not for me. The gold is for the toll. I collect the toll. I collect the gold. Me? No.
Inventory.
没有想到他会自爆，哎，太爽了吧！就喷了一堆钱出来。
Maybe I need more pockets.
That might be worth a look.
Dally.
Don't burn yourself.
Curious.
Let's get going.
Lannister's not around, so might as well.
Let's get on with it. Can't give up now. That took the edge off. I wonder if the gods are watching me.
That's curious.
That we could laugh at, okay? Yes, that is very fucking fake. That is faker than an average titty in West Hollywood. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, simple as that. Let's go to the real meat and potatoes.
Please.
Now, last week we looked at this video over here, and this one in specific, the blur video of the disappearing airplane. Now, this is a 3-minute and 21-second long video, and obviously I didn't show you the entire video when it started, but to give you a quick grasp of the situation, it showed a jetliner that people believe to be MH370 disappearing like that. Now, of course, before it disappeared, it had a bunch of these balls around it, these circular balls. You can see they didn't have trails, too. So it's wild to actually witness how this situation is going out. It's crazy. And there were people who actually did the research on even those trail balls as well. You can see right here from user Space Jungle Boogie, the orbs and airliner videos, analysis of multi-axial rotation, speed, size, it's huge, okay? So they calculated the interception speed, they basically, you know, pointed out the exact time codes those orbs took position, two axis rotations of the jet, and I guess the corresponding balls. They even went out to use rotoscope analysis to actually see how these balls were moving. And based on the size of those balls, ladies and gentlemen, they then decided to actually gauge how large these balls were. That is a human being, that is a space testicle, that's Little Mayo, and that's an aerial jet that was apparently abducted. Allegedly abducted. Oh, but don't worry, ladies and gentlemen, it gets even wilder. We're talking about physics analysis, we're talking about the most analysis imaginable. There is a lot of work into the situation to try to disprove this video. And at this moment in time, it's not just physicists, it's not just people from the military or people that have technical expertise. At this moment in time, visual effects artists started to get into the situation. So this is allegedly a VFX effect that was used when the plane was portaling away. So to show you exactly what I'm talking about over here, towards the tail end of the video, we get a little bit of a zoom in to these balls, but also we get a zoom in to when the plane portaled away. So right here, you can see this is when allegedly the plane was teleported. Now, initially, I thought maybe it exploded, maybe something happened, but no, this was literally a teleportation. So we saw one frame, this is the second frame, third frame, and then fourth frame, and then fifth frame, and then the portal is invisible. So 5 frames of an interdimensional portal, allegedly. So now this is where VFX artists started to cross-reference visual effects of explosions from across the internet, okay? Now to understand, this is a degree of insanity that one should never ever jump into. But this shows you the level of energy some people have to either prove UFO existence or disprove. I can make a ton of videos just talking about the disproval science, the disapprovals, the science it takes to go against, you know, UFO footage. There's a lot of intelligent people on both sides. And this is a situation where it seems like as time passes, those who are often critical and skeptical usually get the story right. Now, 2 days ago, Icy Slide 7698. Dude, I love these names. The plane's video has visual effects and elements used for the portal and is likely a hoax. The effect used is from an old VFX CD-ROM from the 90s.
Forget it. It's blocked from behind.
On archive.org. Yeah, apparently it's from Pyromania, Playing with Fire. Visual effects on CD-ROM. I had no actual idea that this was just an entire CD set for people who wanted explosion effects. So again, it's just pages of explosion sprite sheets, some of them being in popular games like Command & Conquer, of course, some of them being, actually they have a list of games, right? No, Big Explosion, just they've just got different explosions going around. They've even referenced, it's been in James Bond movies, South Park movies. This is actually just a royalty-free collection, so if you wanted to use this alongside Lucasfilms, Sony Interactive, you can, ladies and gentlemen. So again, they looked at this specific frame, which is why I paused the title. So you've got the rectum of the portal, alright, this is where you go in. And then you've got this like little weird nipple on the very edge. But if you look at the actual like triangle, this is two small triangles, and that's two shapes I want you to remember, okay? Keep that in the back. So inside Pyromania Pro 1997, there's apparently an explosion called Shock BW, which I didn't know that this was a royalty-free effect. It's Star Wars, RoboCop, Beetlejuice, and Adam's Family. This is entirely new information. Now, this effect, I wanted you to remember in your head, okay? Now, this is a game known as 3DO. Now, for record's sake, this is a video uploaded by Jimmy Q-Balls, okay? February 20, 2016, okay? So again, 7 years ago. Now, obviously, some could say, oh, this is a little bit after, the alleged plane disappearance. Now, I want to remind you, these are entirely separate channels covering two entirely different things, okay? Now, for anybody that was I think Killing Time is an old-school boomer shooter that's like a puzzle-oriented title. On Steam, you can buy it for like $11. And of course, you can see that it's got, classic CDS graphics. You've got some Egyptian inspiration, and you've got clowns, okay? So maybe I might actually buy it because of how outlandish it is. Now, at exactly 58 minutes into the one-hour-long playthrough, I guess it must have been a pretty short game. But towards the end of the section, when this explosion happened, you already have seen the graphic, okay? So, again, if one just goes frame by frame into the CGI animation, one will see exactly at this frame, this is the image we're talking about, ladies and gentlemen. So you see that little nip here? In fact, let me put it side by side for you. Now, smaller triangles right over here, and we've got the nipples, we've got the explosion effect going on. And there might be parts of the effect that have been slightly edited, but this looks incredibly close for comfort. Now, obviously, there has been editing in regards to color transition, making this look part of the character. But this is where it seems that this explosion effect has come from. You can even see that beyond this triangle,
we need to find a way forward.
It's moon. It's kind of reflective. Again, resolution, some blurring, a lot of modifications have been added. But this is ultimately where it seems like the research ends. Yes, leave it to a bunch of VFX artists, to a bunch of really, really terminally online individuals like me, to end up finding the patterns. Because some people are just really good at seeing patterns. So I'm really good at seeing. Ladies and gentlemen, that's pretty much where the end of the debunking of this video is coming. Now again, there has still been debate in this situation. One day ago, Free Thinking Girl said the VFX effect used to debunk was the edited. The actual unedited this one. So there is still a bit of delay on the situation. Still a bit of debate on whether this movie is going to be downloaded or a plane teleportation. And this is where I'm going to end the video on, okay? I think at this moment in time, things are severely debunked. What we have with this is probably one of the most convincing, hotly debated pieces of UFO movement around. Tons of people talked about it. There have been not one, but at least three articles deciding to spread, fact-checking on the situation. None of those sites had fact-checking. So again, like a lot of these situations, what I'm really trying to get at is keep an open mind, but also a lot of people sat down wanting to believe this shit was real. But in reality, it seems like it's really relevant. But you know what? Hell AI-generated video. Nothing is going to be believable. And your fact-checking powers are going to require more effort than you can imagine. So yeah, ladies and gentlemen, one of the things to debunk is misinformation. This was misinformation. And if you thoroughly can stamp disapproval on it, and only something that you reel down the road. But for now, you know, let's nip this one in the ass, okay? And if you're still thinking about the Argentina UFO, it's not real, Lois!
What's up, everybody? This is the Dark Verge's man here, and today I'm going to take you down by the river. Larian Studios has lit the internet on fire with their latest dating simulator, one that gives Super Seducer a run for its money. By all accounts, Baldur's Gate 3 is a slam dunk success, and it's now the highest rated PC game on Metacritic ever. There's a lot of games on PC. It has taken one of the top 10 spots for most concurrent players on Steam. On August 6th, apparently the game accounted for 28% of total player time on Steam. Pardon my French, but that's fucking crazy. As far as I've played, Baldur's Gate 3 has been an incredible game, and it is very refreshing.
Another step forward. Let's cook with fire, baby.
locate the spot.
Let's have a look.
No studio is more deserving of this kind of praise than Larian, who has toiled in the mines for far too long. But we're not reviewing the game today. Instead,
imagine the game is way too good.
See if there's anything you need. We don't know when the next blow might land. Take care now.
Seek and you shall find me.
Still alive, so that's progress.
I bet they're close.
Very well.
We're close. I can feel it. The Absolute. Its power is strong here.
won't keep me out.
Halflings and gnomes, order here.
Payday gold in my pouch.
And smells worse. Did the curse do this?
Leaning in, you can see how the
looks set.
Go on, drink. Make it drink.
The liquid burns your throat as you swallow, but otherwise you feel no ill effects.
So have I. When will drink, then you amaze. And the father kept drinking in. Father kept questions done. Finished. Over. Holy drink.
端失败，太扯。
Your belly rumbles as the.
Tell me a false fear.
变了？为什么眼睛变了？为什么我的胸罩露出来了？太多酒了。
research notes, they describe a powerful venom extracted from a rare purple worm. Distiller Thisible Thorm sought to create a fatal poison using the worm's gullet. He procured several parts of a worm gullet, but rinsed one in error. The poison he brewed was noxious, but not fatal. Thisible devoted months to formulating a deadly After exhaustive experimentation, he was able to make a near-deadly extract from the glands. But to complete his poison, Thisible required one last ingredient, the petals of a corpse rose. The book's index revealed Thisible enlisted a courier from Baldur's Gate. Unfortunately, a deep purple stain darkens the final page, obscuring the parcel's destination. Your mind separate with the corpse rose petal.
I'll take that. Blood. A couple turns should do it.
Oof.
Akito.
Akito.
No time to rest. Come on, open up. In.
weapon.
Another step forward.
I'd love to, thanks. Well, well.
Thank you.
easy these days.
Hit the spot.
With haste. Oh, dear.